So we're looking at the Eclipse development environment for Java, and in this chapter we're taking a look at how we can programmatically create a layout without using XML. Now 9 times out of 10 we'll utilize main.xml to declare the structure of a user interface like the one that we're looking at here in the Android emulator. But 1 out of 10 times we'll need to use the activity.java file to programmatically create the layout of the user interface based on permissions, perhaps membership in a group, or permissions users who are unable to see or modify the content of a form. So 9 out of 10 times the content of the form is static, perhaps 1 out of 10 times the content of a form is dynamic. So let's take a look at how this works. So this activity named My Chapter 6 underscore activity is the entry point of the Android application. Now, when the user interface is displayed, we have two choices. Here at the bottom, we have the template code that's commented out that normally would load an XML file and it would automatically write the program to uncompress or inflate the content that it finds. Now, what we're looking at here is a reference to set content view that passes in the object here, which is a linear layout. So let's work our way backwards and understand how this works. So a linear layout is an object that we see at the top of the XML document in main.xml. And the properties that we set, the orientation, the background color, the gravity, are things that we would normally find as an attribute on a node of an XML document, but here we're setting these as properties, calling methods to set the value of these three parameters. And then finally, we're referencing this addView method that we can call multiple times to add multiple objects on the screen. So now let's take another step back and find out how this parameter or this object named R gets created. So this is an instance of the rating bar object, and this is the same text that we'd find inside the XML document for main.xml. But instead of attributes, we're going to call the methods that set the value of the number of stars to 5, the step size to 1. We could also have set it to 0.5, and that would allow halfway increments. And then the next set of parameters that we would normally see as attributes are packaged in another object. So this is actually a third object that we're relying on called layout params. So we could see that the wrap content for the width and the wrap content for the height that we would normally find inside the XML attributes is set programmatically on this layout params object P. And then what we're going to do is attach this P onto the rating bar R before we send it to the linear layout.